Welcome to Beyond the Game on the voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC. I am Jacob Volk. Sitting across from me, Dominic Arbolino, Eric Fischetti, and Nick Ornberger. Nick, welcome back, buddy.
Hey, thank you. I'm done looking at rocks, so I'm good at that. And you know what? I thought I was going to be excited, Jake. I'm a little under the weather today. I am furious about that game one last night. I know we're going to get to it, but I am literally shaking out of anger from that still.
My day was good, too.
Well, we're going to get into it right now. Number to call if you have something on your mind is 516-572-7440. So we all know what game Nick is talking about. Why don't you go ahead and take it?
All right. First of all, to any fan out there saying, well, they had their chances to win, and J.R. Smith was a big problem, and Hill missing that free throw was a big problem also. Yeah, I get it. But when a referee, in the final 3 minutes of the game, in the final 3 minutes, makes calls that stop the game, that strip on Durant from Hill was an absolutely clean pick, and they called it a reach. That's the first thing. They go up four right there. They absolutely stay up four. So I don't understand. Like, that could have been the game ender right there. I know the free throw. And then, obviously, that was a charge. He had set his defensive position. LeBron was in a defensive position. Nowhere in that rule does it say the player can't be moving. Nowhere. You have to set a defensive position. That's it. And he was in position. He was way outside of the restricted area. It was a blown call. Those referees blew this game. I know there were other reasons they lost. J.R. Smith, he has never met a shot he didn't like, but could you be more open last night? He had three or four easy threes that he missed. And then both halves closes out with a bonehead play. Why would you gamble on Steph Curry, the only guy in the league who shoots it from 35 and everybody knows that it's going in? I mean, geez Louise. And then at the end of the game, he dribbles it out. What are you doing? The only thing you could do there is dribble out the clock to make people mad. That's it. That's it. You could have taken that shot because you had 5 seconds, dished it out to LeBron or somebody else who was open. I mean,
LeBron, who has been on fire all night.
I just don't get it. And Hill misses the most important free throw of his life. You're an 80% free throw shooter.
He may have missed that on purpose, though.
Oh, for God. You know what?
Do you think he missed it on purpose?
No, I don't.
I don't think he missed it on purpose. If you just look at his face before the camera, and this is honesty, you know, you could be making jokes about it, but like you could see that he didn't look all clear and stuff. Like, he was definitely nervous.
Sean, the program director, just came in. Is that water you have?
I want to make sure you're okay. Are you okay?
I'm upset.
I'm rubbing
check
off
your
on
pulse.
You.
I would like to give Nick the award for the first person to yell on the show besides Jacob Vaughn.
Thank you.
Yeah, way to go, buddy.
Take a picture. It'll last longer, will you?
I'm furious. I'm absolutely furious.
Are you sure you're not a Cavs fan?
I don't care who wins this series, but I want to know that the team that deserved to win the game won it, and the wrong team won last night. The Warriors didn't deserve that win.
Well, let's not go crazy.
I can't push it that far.
Not in regulation.
In overtime,
they dominated the Cavs.
But when you're a championship team, you got to be able to win in overtime. You got to be able to overcome adversity.
I get it. You're right.
The Cavs got screwed over. There's question about that. The officiating yesterday was atrocious. You're not going to get me to say it wasn't.
Yeah.
But the Cavs had an opportunity to win, and they didn't.
And JR obviously made the idiotic move by not realizing. You could see it clear that he might say, "Oh, I knew we were tied at the end of the game with the interviews." But
he's had a history of doing that too.
But you see it clear anyways. You see it clear that on the video, or like when LeBron's like, "What were you doing?" He said, "I thought we were up." You can see it if you know how to read lips, which is it's so obvious in this video. You could see he says, "I thought we were up." Even if I understand that, you know, they were expecting him to maybe take a timeout so they could draw up a play, that I kind of understand more. But still, with that many, like, come on, you got to be smarter than that.
You have to be smarter. You need to be aware. And you're playing with one of the most cerebral players ever. So how are you not informed? How do you not know that the game's still... I can't.
Chris Webber, 25 years ago.
Isn't LeBron the first player to drop 50 in a playoff game or a finals game and lose?
He could be.
I think so. I saw something like that. Where let's just see, like, with the supporting cast that LeBron has. I mean, I understand, like, the Cavaliers, they did play a good game. They did deserve to win this game. Obviously, the officiating did not help at all.
They deserve to win in regulation. Yeah, let's make
absolutely.
That clear. Yeah, they did not deserve to win in overtime.
Yeah, absolutely. You're right. Thank you for correcting me there. And by the way, very quietly, Kevin Love had a great night last night.
Yes, he did. No question about that.
And you know who else? Nance. Larry Nance. 11 boards. He was working.
Know
Draymond
your role.
Green down low.
Nance did well. No question about
that. You
got
to know your role at that
Tristan
point.
Tristan Thompson did well, too, on the defensive end.
I love how the players are getting feisty, too. Maybe not as feisty as, you know, with Thompson and Draymond, obviously, at the end of the game, you know. But those are two players that I feel like have always been going at it. And they're like, that's
their type of
players. I
hope there are no suspensions. I really hope no one gets suspended.
I don't think
there should be.
You can find players. I don't have a problem with that. But don't suspend them.
But like with Curry and Thompson getting up on LeBron. LeBron saying stuff like, I feel like you need that in the playoffs. I feel like that's something every player should have. You should have that motive to, like, you know, like, talk trash and want to win. Not too much where it's like, where you're like Draymond, to be honest. Because Draymond, he's just crazy. You saw him in the camera, like, doing dance moves to the crowd. We're like, it's just like, what are you doing?
He's our modern-day Dennis
Rodman.
That's
celebrate.
His game. That's his game.
Yeah. Well, he did that at the end of overtime when it was clear the Warriors were going to win.
Yeah, exactly. You know, and I'm saying, so obviously I don't always think you should be that, like, feisty in your game, like, trash talking that much, but I think you definitely should have it a little. It adds to the fire, and I think it's something you need.
I mean, quite honestly, Draymond Green is the seminal reason that the Warriors won yesterday.
Yeah.
He was the best player in overtime, and
yes.
I can't stand Draymond Green. No one hates Draymond Green more than me.
He's not a good three-point shooter, but he made him when it mattered.
Yep, he's the only reason why the Warriors won. You know, I've heard a bunch of people making these excuses for the Cavs. And, Nick, I'm not saying you're making an excuse, but the simple fact is the Cavs had the opportunity to win in overtime, and they didn't. If you're going to beat the best team in the NBA, and you can't tell me if the Warriors aren't the best team in the NBA, you got to be able to overcome adversity.
Do you think last night's performance at all maybe changes LeBron's impact if he wants to stay in Cleveland at all just from that move?
I still think he's leaving. I don't think it matters. I really don't think it matters whether they win this series or not.
Okay.
I will tell you, I hate having this conversation.
Does that change the series?
Say that again, I'm sorry?
Does this move what J.R. Smith did, especially at the end of regulation, does this change the series?
If the Cavaliers would have won Game 1, this series is totally different.
Yeah. First up, there's no guarantee that even if George Hill hits that second free throw, the Warriors are losing that game.
That's true.
You've got 5 seconds left with three of the best shooters in the NBA on your roster in Curry, Durant, and Thompson.
But that's a chance you take. You have a chance to take the lead 5 seconds left, and they have to shoot and make it to beat you. That's a chance you take.
You're absolutely right. But what I'm saying is there's no guarantee that the Cavs would have won.
Excuse me. I didn't understand. Yes. Okay. So, yeah, it's not a guarantee, but that's why I don't think the Hill miss was on purpose.
No, I've just seen that mentioned on Twitter, and I thought it was worth bringing up. I don't think it was on purpose either. I think you make the free throws. You make the team make the last shot.
I mean, something did benefit from it. Twitter.
Yeah, right. Oh, my
see
God.
See all those memes? Oh.
I will tell you, I was live tweeting the game, and I kind of went quiet in the second half, but in the last, like, 5 minutes of the fourth quarter, it's like, okay, let me get back on Twitter. What's my password again?
I didn't start until the refereeing blunders.
Yeah, that's because you were on air.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Actually, I wasn't.
Really?
Excuse me, I wasn't in last night.
Oh, wow. Good for you. You took off. I give you a ton of credit.
Don't go. Come on.
To be prepared for this show, that's why.
Yeah, exactly.
That's right. I was preparing for a particular debate.
Oh, yes. Oh, that's going to be fun. Stay tuned for that. I thought about coming in with a judge's rope and a gavel full.
I told you.
I really wish you did that.
A gavel full of Jack Daniels.
You should have came in with an Aaron Judge shirt. There you go.
An Aaron Judge shirt. I like that.
That could have worked, too.
I think somewhere I have a foam judge's wig. I know that. I mean, my father's an attorney, so
you
he goes
never,
as a...
Ever, wait, I swear, wait, you
so
never cease
just
to amaze
judges
me.
Judges when he leaves court?
My father's an attorney, so he goes as a judge for Halloween.
Oh, okay.
So
original.
That's where it is there. Yeah, exactly. Very original. No one is more original than my father, I'll tell you that right now.
He's your dad. You only got one.
Oh, my goodness gracious. Was there anything else about the finals that we wanted to talk about? I don't want to leave any stone unturned.
I just think the one other thing I'll say is Tristan Thompson needs to be smarter than that at the end of the game. That's what Draymond Green's whole game is, get you out of your game. So don't don't buy into it. Just walk away.
Especially that he made it throughout the whole game, too, and then it was just at the end.
I will tell you, I don't mind Thompson doing that. I don't mind Green doing that. It's the end of a very emotional game that the Cavs should have won. And at the end of the game, when you're getting blown out in overtime, they lost, I think, 17-7 in overtime. I mean, I don't mind that. Tempers are going to boil over. I get that.
We are going to see a lot of Coach LeBron during this whole series.
And what I love- the first quarter of Game 2 is going to be the most important quarter of basketball this year.
I think the Cavs are going to come out swinging.
If the Warriors are up by 17 at the end of one, the game, and maybe the series, is over. No question about that.
Okay, so what do you think about a Warriors sweep? Do you think that's like very, very, very possible now?
I mean, I said it was possible on Tuesday. I picked Warriors in 5, but I said a sweep was possible. I wouldn't bet against the Warriors sweeping them. The only thing they have to do is slow down LeBron. And I don't know when Iguodala's coming back, but with him coming back, we've seen it before. He can slow down LeBron. And Durant, even though we didn't see it last night, has slowed down LeBron in the past.
Yeah.
It's just that simple.
And what I have to mention real quick, too, is that what I love to see is that obviously you saw Klay Thompson get injured, and then he was able to come back, obviously, and he just obviously
that was
made
not a dirty play by J.R. Smith.
No, no, I think he just slipped.
But he did.
He made a huge impact in the game. And then one interesting fact that I heard from the broadcasting team yesterday is that Klay Thompson...
Jeff Van Gundy is horrible, by the way.
Yes,
I can't stand him.
Other than that, Klay Thompson has started every playoff game for the Warriors.
Yes, in the past 4 years.
Yep.
Wow. He's
so
been amazing.
I think that's something like you got to take notice of, that he's been able to grind it out.
Sorry. There was rumor that before Love was traded to the Cavs, that Love was going to be traded to the Warriors for Klay Thompson.
Wow.
For the Warriors' sake, I'm glad they didn't do that trade.
Yeah.
Klay Thompson is one of the most underrated players in the NBA. I mean, I love Klay Thompson out of Washington State, and his father was a hell of a player.
I remember in the beginning of the season when you saw, remember when all those rumors came out about, oh, is LeBron going to join the Warriors next year? How will it happen? No, it's definitely not going to happen.
Here's why it's not going
to
happen.
I feel like they have to give up Klay or something like that. They're going to have to get rid of people, and it's not worth it.
Here's why it's not going to happen. The NBA won't allow it.
Yeah, no, I don't.
They'll come up with something.
It shouldn't happen.
Chris Paul situation.
Yeah, I was just about to say that. Very good, Nick. I was just about to say that.
I don't think it's going to happen, but it's just like you see those like rumors thrown out there, and I wouldn't do that anyways. LeBron is obviously the best player in the NBA, but you have such a group and a core working right now.
I think a dark horse candidate for LeBron is Houston.
Yeah, I think Houston.
I don't think he should go out west,
I'll tell you
west,
one
though.
Thing. I'll tell Why? You one.
Well, Sorry. Number one, if you go out west, you're going to have to deal with the Warriors a lot more. Why go out west, where it's obviously going to be a dogfight, where you can stay in the east and probably have an easier path to the finals every year you're in the east?
So you're saying Philly?
I'm still saying, I don't think he's going to leave.
Oh, okay.
But I think it's more possible that he leaves than stays. Me just personally, I don't think he's going to leave. But yeah, I would say that a dark horse candidate is Philadelphia. Yeah.
Okay. No problem.
I've even heard Boston being thrown around. I can't really see that. I would say if he's staying in the east, he's staying in Cleveland or going to Philadelphia.
I don't see him going to the Lakers. I've seen that bandied about a lot. I don't see that. I don't see the Clippers. I think it's going to be either the Rockets or the Sixers.
Yeah.
I'll be honest with you.
I disagree.
You.
I think the Lakers are a team that's built for him, and to have another shot creator, another playmaker like...
What shot creator do they have?
Not shot creator. I'm sorry. Another playmaker like Lonzo Ball in his maturation process, having a guy like LeBron to coach him through it.
But it's the same thing as he has in Cleveland. No supporting cast.
You
think Brooke Lopez is his supporting cast?
No. Brandon Ingram's coming along.
Yeah. I hate Kyle Kuzma, though.
Why? Just because he was taken with a Nets pick?
Exactly.
What?
Yeah, that's exactly
also,
why.
Kuzma is a good player.
I hate Draymond Green, too, for that exact same reason. Yeah, well, no, not just because
Draymond's a little different.
I hate Jaylen Brown. I hate Jason Tatum. I hate Enes Kanter.
What a team that the Nets would have had.
Oh, my goodness. Please tell me you guys watched that YouTube video.
I felt bad.
Good. Oh, man. That is painful. So, the 76ers are part of one of the strangest sports stories in recent memory. According to Ben Detrick of The Ringer, Brian Colangelo has been using burner accounts on Twitter to defend himself and to criticize 76ers players. You can't make this stuff
up. It's Kevin Durant 2.0.
It's Skip Bayless 2.0.
Oh, my God.
You can't make this stuff up.
Oh, my gosh.
He since denied that. I can't keep a straight face over this. He since denied this, but may still lose his job over it, according to Keith Pompey of the Philadelphia Inquirer. Brian, if this is true, you have to be one of the biggest idiots
chance in the world.
If this ends up being true, that's it. He can kiss his NBA possibly career, like having a job in
his
the NBA.
His body's got to be ashamed of himself.
Like this is something that preteens do to figure out if their crush likes them. No, like honestly,
I
should have
done that.
This is just so out of left field. Like what?
He was crying.
He was.